down and shoot this way. So make sure this area is clear. Watch your feet jump like that.
We're gonna come down this way, and we're gonna come down here.
So I'm saying when they come down the steps, just watch your feet. We're gonna go around the back, we're gonna come in here. Naturally, when they come down, we're gonna be standing. We're gonna make them feel as welcome as possible in North Pittsburgh. So just when we let everybody go down and around the center, make sure nobody trips the president and CEO of our company. Talk about PR, that's not a good PR. And if you do, you've got to catch them. Or play a Tim Boucher. Either way.
Thank you.
our then CEO of American Income.
Marcus Smith. Alexandra Berberich.
$3,000.
paid out in bonuses, just in bonuses for the week, just in bonuses, $216,000.
$400 out of the Antonio Reyes and Agency.
$6,500 in income out of South Hills, Britton Costa. $7,300 here in Wexford, Chuck Ferrari. John Kennard, $7,500 out of Hurricane, West Virginia, John Kennard. Tommy, $7,800 in income out of Erie, KC Kunak. $8,800, y'all do nothing separate, huh? $8,800 in income, Albie Serrer. Tied with $8,800 in income, Albie Connor. Number nine in income right now.
Roger Smith! James Kiefer, stand up for a second. So I want you to listen to this, because sometimes the same people's name gets called all the time and they stand up and so on. But James is seventh among all producers at American Eagle. Each year, that competition gets tougher and tougher and tougher. So in 1999, when I first came and took over here, there was like 1,100 agents. You would think the competition was pretty damn strong then, right? Yeah. Yep. Today, he's competing against 6,700 agents. Level number 18 is Kashif Perkins. Kashif,
he's in West Virginia. West Virginia.
Number 15, Michael May. Number 8, Joseph McAllister. The number 2 essay, throughout the country, throughout the world, Jenna Grillo.
Tommy Nina!
was in the house. We got 3,200 Erica Fitzsimmons, 2,500 Bill Hart, 3,600 Bryson Moore, 4,000 Sarah Morrow, 4,400 Jessica Holman, 4,800 Andy Lee Brown, 5,500 Risa Davis, 5,500 Bobby Carter, 7,000 Tim Bouger, 7,000 Blake Williams, 7,800 Jordan Albright, 7,800 Andrew Wagner, 8,100 Mike May, 11,000 Bobby Miller.
Motown, we got a bunch of 2,000 Carol Murkowski. 2,100 Ryan LeBeau. 2,500. I'm sorry, I'm late. 2,500. 2,900 Kara Goodwin. 3,000 Jessica Botello. 3,500 Greg Vinson. 2,700 Jamie Goldman. 2,800 Christina Yao. 6,500 Selena. Led the way, the three of them combined. They combined for almost 60,000. Matt Haley from Erie / Blacksburg, 22 years old. He rode almost $17,000 in business. Jump started the weekend for us.
And that's why I average, and if you know your numbers the same way, just focus on getting those numbers. Follow the script, follow your upline, everything else will work out. That's it, guys.
We had dinner last night with some of the award winners, and I asked a question, and I said, does anybody know why Roger and Larry are here? And a couple people said, well, because we had our record-breaking week, but this trip was planned way before we ever planned on having a record-breaking week. And I say all that because some of you that have been around a while know the magnitude of Roger and Larry's position with Torchmark and American Income, and how much that means, leading companies that are that big, the amount of time that you have or lack thereof. I know that they can't go out and visit each and every agency, and I don't know of many times, if ever, they've ever traveled together to an agency like this.
First time ever.
Company for going on 40 years this year. We talked last night, 40 years. So imagine if you've done 5 years, 10 years, imagine how much he has seen, how many sacrifices have been made to take us to this point, to be with this company for 40 years. Forbes, I took a quote from Forbes, and in Forbes it said, Torchmark was in it for the top 10 corporations for transparency and accounting systems. And I think that's important because to have Larry here, in the amount of time that I've had the opportunity to spend time with Larry, I could just tell you, if I could just sum it up with one word, it's trust. Trust, 100%. If there was ever any, if there was a fraction of a percentage on me being worried about this company's future, it was squashed when I met Larry. Because to spend time with Larry is to know that you can trust him. And that's what Forbes said, that Torchmark, due to Larry and his leadership and the people that he has in place, was listed as one of the top 10 corporations for transparency and accounting systems. That's the culture that he's brought. That on a Sunday flies here to spend time with us, and the first thing I seen in his hand when I met him at the hotel was a pink bag, a gift for my unborn child in a couple weeks to my daughter from him and his wife. Roger has been the president and CEO since 2003. He was actually the vice president with our company in 1999. So we looked up some statistics on what has happened over the last 16 years. Since Roger came into leadership at the corporate level with this company over the last 16 years, when he started, we had 1,100 agents. We just all heard that there's 6,700 agents right now under the leadership. Woo! We were doing $50 million a year when Roger took over in leadership with this company, and this year it sounds like we're going to break $200 million in net premium. One of our sister companies brought Roger in 2011 to be the CEO over at Liberty. As they needed some leadership like we had here at American Income. It had been a long time since they had had growth, let alone double-digit growth. Last year, Liberty had double-digit 12% growth under Roger Smith's leadership. This is a CEO that years ago when I was nervous to just meet Roger, he came down with this awesome chain at convention, and it had a Chrome Hearts dagger on it. And I told him, I complimented him on how much that I liked his chain. And for dinner that night, I had the opportunity to meet Roger's dad. And at dinner, he handed me this box. And in that box was the chain off of his neck. This is the CEO that we have. And since that point, you know, one of the biggest moments of my life, you know, Tommy or Justin or somebody brought up the fact that one of my dreams was to open up a youth program in Youngstown, Ohio. I don't know many CEOs that make time to fly out yet again a couple weeks ago to Youngstown, Ohio, in the middle of nowhere to support me and us in a youth program. And not only did he show up, he showed up with his checkbook ready too. This is the CEO that we have an opportunity to serve and lead us. So guys, I just wanted to not only welcome, but Roger and Larry, we just wanted to thank you. That's why we had our record week, was to show you how much that we appreciated the duo coming out here. But thank you very much for coming out here.
That he has provided, and not only the leadership in business card. But the leadership and core values, you know, Tommy. He said that things, you know, that we used to always say, take out of the community, put back into the community. That's a part of who we are as a company. That's part of our core values. That's a part that we were kind of born under. And Simon, you just epitomized that. We just epitomized what you're going to just follow me around with. Being a leader and giving back to the community, this company is going to be in great, great hands. You were at convention. Good number, right? Is that a great convention? So, as you can probably figure out, I'm a little speeched out at this point. So what I want to do is I just want to talk to you for about 10 minutes and kind of give you my four golden rules, kind of rules that I've lived by, and then maybe what we can do after that is I can open it up for questions. And and then I can open it up for questions, and then maybe there'd be some questions about Torchmark, and Larry could answer, okay? So these rules have kind of carried me from when I was an agent 40 years ago to today as CEO for both American Income Life and Liberty National. So some of you have heard these before. That's okay. They're repeating. So let me do the number one rule. Number one rule is burn your bridges. And I know that you've been taught from probably, you know, early childhood and on, and they go, don't burn your bridges. Don't burn your bridges. And I'm saying the opposite, folks. I'm saying burn every damn bridge that you can. And there's a reason. The reason is that you can't and don't want to give yourself an escape hatch. I'm going to tell you something. This is hard. I know some guys are, man, this is so easy from what I was doing. I'm going to tell you, you just haven't hit the hard spot yet. Okay? This is hard. And I don't care whether you're an agent, an SA, a GA, an MGA, an RGA, an SGA. This is hard to stop. And if you take that, the simple premise that, you know, if it was easy, everybody would have it, right? Well, it isn't easy. It's hard. And when hard times come, and when you hit those obstacles, and they don't hit you soft, they hit you hard. If you've set yourself up to say, oh, you know what, if this doesn't work, I'll go do this. You know, if you're a new SA, and you sit there and go, well, you know, if it doesn't work, I'll be an agent again. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy. You're setting yourself up for failure. Listen, I was by far the worst salesperson that American Income has ever had. And I was the number one agent in the company. I'm telling you, I was the worst. So, you know how they teach you when you close, you know, stay your closing line and then the first person who talks loses? First of all, I don't like that at all, because the reality of it is that if somebody makes the decision to become a policyholder of American Income and National Income, they're the winners, right? You're not the beneficiaries. They've made the beneficiaries in their home, they've secured. So they're the winners. But the reality of it is, once again, the first person who talks is the one that relieves the pressure, right? So I used to close, give the closing line, and the God's honest truth. I'd break into a sweat. I mean, not like a little wipe your head sweat, you know. I mean, I'd break into a body sweat. And the back of my neck would start to shake so hard that I thought that they thought I was having an epileptic seizure. The funny part about this is it didn't get easier as I went along in my career, you know. My first group interview, oh my God, I was so nervous. I was going to get up, try to sell people on American Income. I was so scared. And oh my God, wait for me doing my first convention. Just so serious, so much fear. And if at any time, at any moment, if I had said to myself, if this doesn't work, I'll do something else, I guarantee I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you today. Dr. Chris Gardner, who was the guy that wrote the book, Pursuit of Happiness, that Will Smith played. Anyway, he came and he talked at our convention one time. And he had this great line. He said, he said, if Plan B was any good, it'd be Plan A. Plan B sucks. It does. So why have it? Why have it? Okay? Don't give yourself an escape hatch. Burn your bridges. Know what you're going to do. Have the perseverance, the fortitude to keep doing. Okay? That's number one rule. Here's number two. Number two. Be the dragon slayer. And I say this to those of you that are in a leadership position. People need to be shown what to do. It's no longer any good to be able to say, hey, go do this. You know, here's how you do it. Let me show you the presentation. Now go do it. What you need to do is you need to show people how to do it. And so what I ask you to do is to be humble enough to remember where you came from. I mean, we handed out, you handed out, you talked about some huge checks. You start talking about 20,000, 17,000, 15,000, 10,000. The low number was 2,000 or something? What did you start? 3,000? 50,000. Have you ever seen anything like that? Have you ever heard of anything like that? And what happens when you hear that and you see it and it happens all the time, you take it for granted? I'm going to tell you something. There's a lot. Who's new in this room? Who's like just learning the presentation? I hope I can go. Okay. I hope I can get to know about it. Because it's scary sometimes. When I first started, I had a real problem selling retirees. And I was 22 years old. You know, what did I have? How was I going to relate to somebody in their 50s or 60s or 70s? I didn't even know how I was going to talk to them about death, considering I'd never known anybody who died, you know? And here I was going to talk about security for the family. And I'm telling you, I had a hard time. And I was fortunate enough. I was fortunate enough to have a supervising agent who said, Roger, you know what we're going to do? Tomorrow, you're going to set all your appointments. I don't want us to see anybody under age 60. We're going to run from 9 in the morning, from 9 at night, and all we're going to do is see retirees. And you know what? After that, I never had a problem with this. Never had a problem because somebody took the time to slay my dragon, to slay my fears. So be that way. Help somebody else. Help them slay their fears. Okay? That's number two. Number three, nothing's as good as it seems, nothing's as bad as it seems. This is really important. I actually think that every disappointment, every failure is God's way of saying, let's build some character in this person. And I'm telling you, the bad times are gonna pass, and the good times are gonna pass too. In fact, right about the time that you're finished patting yourself on the back for something that you did is about the same time that you're saying, how did I get into this mess? So I'm going to tell you, when I took over in 1999, I got a call from the founder of Bernard Rappaport, and he said, Roger, would you think of running the company? And right before that, I'd kind of gone into semi-retirement in South Carolina, and I thought, oh my goodness, man, they're asking me, this is my dream, man. They're asking me to come and run this company. And I thought, it's my heart, it's my soul. And I couldn't have been any higher at that moment than with that call, right? I got down to Waco, and at that point, Mr. Rappaport retired, the president of the company, Chuck Cooper, resigned, and the executive vice president, I don't know what happened to him. So it was myself, and it was Debbie Gamble. And Debbie started asking me questions. And it was at that moment that I realized I don't know anything about running a company. In fact, I literally said to myself, if I owned any Torchmark stock at that time, I would have sold. But nothing good was about to happen. I did not have the credentials to do this. So can you imagine that high from that phone call to that low, realizing that epiphany moment that you don't know what you need to know to be able to do what you need to do? Right? Listen, either that pendulum's going to swing you, or you can control that pendulum. It's why we lose people. It's because they get these high highs, and then all of a sudden they blank the next couple weeks, and they have these low lows, and they swing from here to here. Try to figure it out. Try to make it more consistent. Do what you need to do to make sure that your highs are as high, your lows are as low. Nothing's as good as it seems, nothing's as bad as it seems. I wish that as you start doing, you know, your inspiring minds and so on, I wish that we could get that message across to these young teenagers that you know, commit suicide. It's like the world is just so bad and all these horrible things are happening. I wish we could get that message across to them and say, hey, this too shall pass. It's not as bad as you seem.
I'll video tape it when I give that speech to him. Huh?
Yeah,
that'd be a great thing.
All right, and then let me give you number four. And I gotta tell you, I'm working on this. I got the other one pretty well mastered. I have not mastered this one. So the fourth rule is respond, don't react. Respond. Don't react. Now, you want to think about it. God made you with a mind and the ability to use logic.
Yeah, way better at this, right?
Every time I've taken a step backwards in my life, and I'm going to tell you, there's been plenty of those, it's because I let my emotions get the best of me. I reacted to the situation instead of taking my time, thinking it out, and then responding to the task at hand. The majority of my regrets have come from reacting and impulse. Almost every major fight that I've ever had in my life, wife, kids, SGAs, cares, has come because I reacted to a situation. I didn't control it. I didn't put it in my head. I reacted emotionally. Instead of responding and telling them. You know, we learn that we motivate with emotion. If I want to get you motivated, if I want to get you with your passions running, man, just like you guys did this morning, I'm going to do that with emotion. But if I want to deal with a negative with you, I'm going to deal with it with data. I'm going to control it with data. I'm going to respond with the things that need to be responded to. Like I said, the next time, I mean, there's a million cliches that talk about, okay, count to 10 before we do the million cliches. But I'm telling you, it is the things that will get you in trouble to react to things instead of responding. So anyway, those are my rules. I hope they can help you through your journey with American Income. You are part of a great, great, great company. There's so much more ahead of it. And the better part of it, that you're a part of a great, great, great agency. An agency that is constantly making history and writing history in the chapters of American Income and how a great, great leadership can do. So listen, thank you guys. Thank you for your time. Okay.
So my first question, I guess this would be more so for Larry, would be what role does American Income play in Torchmark? And then with that being said, where do you see Torchmark in the next 10 years?
Okay. Question.
This is relevant. The American Income plays in Torchmark. It's the most profitable, it's the largest company within Torchmark. That said, you're part of something a lot bigger than just American Income. American Income is about 36%, about a third of the underwriting profits of Torchmark. We've got two other agencies who have a direct mail operation, with a lot of investment income. So what's important is American Income, you know, is what's important for the sum of the parts. For Family Heritage, for International, for American Income, United American Income, for NOCO, and then United America and New York. So that's the essence.
our direct response.
And I showed you guys the emotion.
Yeah, we need the emotion. When you talk about that market, so 50% of that market doesn't have any life insurance. As much as we're selling now, we reach about 1% of that market. So the other one question is, why don't you look overseas, why don't you go to Europe, why don't you go to Asia? There's no reason to. Our market's here. I would say in the U.S. and Canada, and sure, there's opportunities elsewhere, but let's first grow these companies here. This is not a sanitary market.
Okay. Two more questions?
Yeah, questions for both of you guys. First of all, how did you both get into the business? How did you guys both get into the business? And also, what's your goal to become, or your vision to become a CEO? How did that develop, going from an agent to a CEO?
Roger, why don't you go first?
Actually, my stepfather started with American Income about 6 months before I did. And actually, he was the original charter member of the President's Club in 1974, something like that. So yeah, that was pretty cool. No way did I ever think that I would be CEO. Never had the thought, never, you know, it was God, man. That's, I don't know how else to say it. I can't give you another explanation that, you know, that, you know, I was blessed to be able to come in and run this company. And that blessing has continued. So, yeah, good stuff.
I think you're in a different position because I talk to labor, everybody knows
interest in Notch moving forward with that?
We are looking at a couple of packages where, you know, maybe in the book that they hand out, maybe, you know, six times a year, having a full page ad, American Income Recruited, yeah. You know, and we're looking at maybe putting it together with, you know, with Houston, maybe look at Pittsburgh. We're going to look at some of these teams and maybe do a test on that side. That's where I think the money spent will bring us the best return.
I'll test it out.
Thank
you. Whenever this decision, happens, where we're looking at other, you know, maybe areas for stuff like this, just remember, Pittsburgh is noted. Internationally, kind of as the city of champions, has a bunch of championships. So, guys, in closing, I know we got some folks that have been in the business for 40 years and people that have been with me since we founded this place 7 years ago. What I'll close in saying is two things. Number one, if the last time Roger was here, I met my wife. At a tailgate party in Pittsburgh, my assistant Natalie brought Natalie, and he came because we did $100,000 in a week, and it was actually 6 years ago. So if you go from $100,000 to $740,000, I believe loaded, that's 7.5 times that amount 6 years ago. So. Watch some of you folks get married and have kids, and we've expanded and got married and got other offices and have a bunch of kids. But if you want to know where somebody's going, just kind of take a peek at where they've been. And I believe that you're only as good as the players that you have an opportunity to lead. We're blessed with great people that I have the privilege to lead, and that's why we've done what we've done over the last 7 years. But if you could just fast forward time with me and think of 7 times the amount of the number we just put up this week, or 7 times the amount the number we're getting ready to put up in about 90 days. When you look 7 times that amount 7 years later, you're going to find that's a $7 million week. And you got to ask yourself, out of that $7 million, that extra $6.3 million a week in premium, how much of that can be coded to my name to take care of my mom, my dad, my grandparents, my youth program, my daughter going to Harvard, whatever it is that you want, that's kind of where we're going. I've told some athletes in here, it's like being with the Bulls in the 90s. It's like being with the Patriots winning a bunch of Super Bowls right now. It's like being with the Yankees when they were exploding. It's like being with UCLA when Coach Wooden was the coach and they ripped off 11 titles in a row. We are literally in the right place at the right time. And it couldn't be better timing to do what you're doing. So, guys, thank you for being here. Let's continue.